Good morning. Today I'd like to show you how I use a looper to practice my scales and guitar bits. The scales that I really like a lot are the BB King box and the pentatonic scale. To me, those are very, very simple scales. So I'm gonna set up my looper, show you how I set it up, how I plug it in, and offer you different ways that you can plug it in and what you could use the equipment with. I'm using a Boss Looper RC1, and I'm also using a Boss Guitar Effects, the GT1. So they're both very low priced things that you could have great time with. And I can sit and play with these two things for hours while I'm learning. So here is the video, and hopefully it helps you out. And let's get started. I'll record a rhythm, then a bass, and then maybe some kind of beat, or if you have a drum machine, run a drum machine through it. Or even better yet, if you have an iPhone or an Android, just go ahead and plug it into one of the inputs and use any drum machine app that you can find. So the way I'm hooking this up, I want my effects processor to run into my loop station so that it records what I have. And then when I change this, I do not want it to affect the sounds that I've recorded on here. We're gonna plug the guitar into the Boss GT1. From there, we're gonna go, it's gonna run through the outputs. You can use the mono or you can use both, and that will go into the inputs of the loop station. Again, you could use mono or both, it doesn't matter. And that will go out to your amplifier, speaker, or your PA system. Okay, so I'm gonna put my guitar running in to my Boss GT1, and from there I'm going to run the outputs. You can use just one or you can use two, it doesn't matter, and I'm going to run those into the input of the loop station, and from there I'm going to run that into my PA system. Okay, now you can run this to your PA system, a speaker, a mixer, anything that you want to have the sound come out of, because your sound follows the signal. Guitar in, right there, goes through here, then it goes out, then comes into your loop station, and that signal goes through here, then it goes out there to whatever source you want to have it go to. Now, if I just wanted a mono output, I would just, again, plug in one, and I would bring that into my mixer or my amplifier or whatever source you want to run for your sound. Okay, now I'll get a bass sound. When I'm practicing like this, two scales that I will practice a lot is my version of a pentatonic scale and the BB King box. To me, those are the easiest, and I can visualize them up and down the neck. We'll start with a pentatonic scale. BB King box. And then you can go ahead and do another chord. Get your fingering all down for that. Maybe you want to do a D. So you could do a D next. And then, I usually will do A and then B, C, D. this is the way that I practice and get to know my scales, and I can practice a song if I'm trying to learn a part. It just really enhances your guitar playing. Having a looper is the best practice that I had ever used. Thank you to my buddy Ken. So he taught me how to use the looper and how invaluable it is, and especially while he was teaching me the pentatonic scales. Pentatonic and the B.B. King have been the most valuable lessons I have learned, and I use them all the time. And once you learn to see them up and down the fretboard, you be in great shape. And again, the looper's the best way I know to practice. So, you know, nothing's set in stone. Add some notes here and there like I do, and just play it, you know, with your own flavor to it. And just learn them, and you'll start seeing them. So take care, have a great day, and go out and get yourself a looper and start looping.